Guys, welcome back. So in today's video, you guys are gonna get ready with me just for an everyday typical makeup look. But before we get into that, make sure you go down there and hit that subscribe button. All right, so now that that's done, we can go ahead and get into the video. So the first product that we're gonna be going in with today is gonna be the Becca First Light Priming Filter. And I'm sure you guys saw me use this when, get it in the haul video. And since that haul, I've been using it and it's so good. So even though I'm really oily, I like to use this before my matte foundation just to make my skin look more skin-like. All right, so the next product that we're gonna be going in with is gonna be the Superstay Maybelline 24 Hour Matte Foundation. I usually do like 1.5, maybe 2 pumps, and that's gonna work for your whole face plus your neck. And then I'm gonna go ahead and take a Real Techniques sponge and just go ahead and blend that out all over the face. Actually just gonna go in with a little bit more because I did 1.5, but I'm gonna do like the tiniest dot more just for my neck. Even if the shade does match me, I would always blend down to my neck just so everything seems perfect. Okay, so now that that is all blended out, we're just gonna add a little bit of concealer. I like to use the Tarte Shape Tape. And we're just gonna go ahead and apply a little bit of this under the eye to brighten up that area and a little bit in the center of the face. This is a very full coverage concealer, so I try to just do a little bit. Since I mainly just use it for like brightening. And then go ahead and blend that out with the same sponge that you were using before. There we go. Okay, so now that that is blended out, we're gonna go ahead and set it. I use the Derma Blend Loose Setting Powder. It is very white, but on my skin tone, it doesn't have flashback, and it doesn't leave a white cast, which is what I like about it. But if you're medium to darker skin tone, I don't think you're gonna really like this powder. Okay, and then I do this with a Morphe M438 brush. And I just take a little bit and then I go ahead and just apply that right under my eyes. And I basically just use this powder wherever I had applied concealer, but I only take a very tiny amount. Okay, and then on to the next step. So I usually use like a pressed powder for this, but since I ran all out of mine, I just use Airspun and I take a light amount of that and I just apply that all over the face to set it. And I do that with a E41 Morphe brush. And I don't know if you guys noticed, I also like use this brush to like kind of wipe away the area that I baked. I don't know, I just basically, I don't really call it baking, I call it that setting, because if I was gonna bake it, I would have left it there a lot longer. Okay, and then for the next step, I actually use the MAC Fix Plus to just set my face now to make it look more like skin instead of so powdery and like my makeup's just sitting on top. And then you're just gonna go ahead and like try to dry it. It's wet. Oh, let's use this palette. And then so for the next step, I'm gonna go ahead and do my eyebrows, but I'm actually gonna do those off camera. If you guys wanna see how I do my eyebrows, I'll do a whole tutorial dedicated to just that. And I'm back. All right, so now that the eyebrows are done, I'm just gonna go ahead and bronze the face with the Hoola Benefit Bronzer. And I take this on a Morphe R2. And I also just apply this around my forehead, so it's more shaded and doesn't look so big. Okay, so now that that is done, I am just gonna go ahead and apply some blush. I take the Milani Baked Blush in the shade Luminoso. Okay, so now that that is applied, we are actually gonna go ahead and apply highlight. So this is literally my favorite highlight palette ever, and I use it every day, but unfortunately it's not available anymore. It's the Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit, the Nicole Guerrero one. Like, mine's dirty, but like, you can't tell me this isn't a gorgeous palette. Like, if you have this, like, if you have this palette, like, you'll know. But they need to bring it back because, like, this should be a staple. Ugh, it's just so beautiful. Like, all the pinky tones, like, goldens, like, golden bronze shades. Ugh, I'm obsessed. Like, there's literally a shade in here for everybody. And I use all of them. Especially like this one looks beautiful on me when I'm like really dark in the summer, and then if I'm white, I use like really pale in the winter, I'll like mix these two shades. It's just it's gorgeous. I'm obsessed. Okay, so now I'm just gonna go ahead and apply that onto this area. I'm gonna take this shade Daydream, which is more of like a peachy pink shade. And I should just mention that if you guys keep seeing me look down, it's because you guys are here, but right below you, I have a mirror. So if that bothers you, I'm sorry. And yes, I know I have texture right here, but I don't care because I love this highlight. So I'm still gonna apply it. And then I always just apply some on my nose and like a tiny bit on the bridge of it. Like that. We'll apply just a little bit more. Because come on, like this is gorgeous. Like, especially when the sunlight hits it. Ladies, you'll be blinding people from outer space. I promise you. Okay, so the next thing, basically for my eyes, I keep it pretty simple day to day. So I literally just take any blender brush, like literally anyone you have will work for this. And I take my bronzer, dip my brush in my bronzer, and I literally just put in the crease. Because who has time for eyeshadow every day? Not me. Let me tell you that. Okay. After you do that, go ahead and go back in with whatever highlight you have, because I know this isn't available anymore, but there's so many highlighters out there. I mean, I'm sure just take whatever one's your favorite and take a tiny brush, like a tiny pencil brush, and take whatever highlight shade and pop it right into the inner corner. Oh my God, I just made my eye itchy. It's so itchy. Why is it so itchy? How? I'm shook. Like, oh my God. I don't care if I'm not supposed to do this. I'm still gonna. Oh my God, it's so itchy. Okay. Did I mess up my makeup? No, it didn't. Okay, so my eye just was like, I don't know, my brush like attacked me, I guess. Okay, and then we're gonna be going in with mascara. I don't really love this mascara. There is a lot of better ones out there, like the L'Oreal Lash Paradise mascara or the Too Faced Better Than Sex, Benefit, what is it, Roller Lash. There's a lot, like, if you guys like want to know like my favorite mascaras or like favorite beauty products, I can do a whole video on that later on. But yeah, just let me know. But yeah, this one isn't great. It's only okay. And my mirror's dirty, so if you guys see it, yeah. See, mascara, no mascara. Like, it makes such a big difference, ladies. Like, oh, it just brings so much more attention to the eyes. Like, okay, and then so after applying mascara, I just take a little bit of black eyeliner, I apply that to the lower like waterline, and then I apply more mascara. See the difference? Okay. Okay, and then again, just take same mascara you use, apply it to the lower lashes. I'm so sorry that you guys couldn't see me doing that. I mean, it kind of made a mess, but it's whatever. Told you, every day I always make a mess. And then I just go, no, I don't. Hold up. Lips. Where is it? This is my favorite lipstick. It is MAC Velvet Teddy. Oh, I swear this lipstick has my heart. Guys, it is the perfect nude. At least for me, like, the tube is almost gone, but it's okay because I have a backup in my drawer. That's how much I love it. And then just obviously go ahead and apply this to your lips. Okay. Now that this is all done, sorry, I have like lipstick in the corners. I mean, I'm not perfect, like, not gonna lie, not that good at makeup. Okay, and then I just take my Maxfix Plus again and set my face to finish off the look. And go ahead and dry it. Okay, and so this is the final look. So thank you guys so much again for getting ready with me. I really appreciate it. If you guys did not already, make sure to subscribe after done watching the video. And I will try to leave the links for almost all of the products that I used down below. And if you did enjoy this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Again, thank you guys so much. I love you all. Have a great rest of your day. Bye.